In the previous video, I had given you this problem. I wanted you to solve by yourself, but none of you have responded to it. Anyway, we are going to solve it now. Now, this is a frame which is unequal in its legs. Okay, the columns are of not equal length. Okay, and there is also a horizontal force that is acting on column AB. So because of this, the structure will sway, as we know that there is no support over here. I had explained to you earlier the conditions in which a frame will sway, right? Unequal legs, if there is a horizontal force being applied, if there is unequal cross section, and then if there is a change in the support also, right? If this is a fixer joint, if this is pin joint, then also there will be a sway. And then one more thing that you need to focus is whether the distribution of load, the load that has been applied, is symmetric or non-symmetric in condition, okay? So these are all the conditions from which you will determine whether the frame will sway or not, okay? Now from this frame, it is very much clear that this is supposed to sway because it is having unequal legs, and then there is also a horizontal force being applied, right? So we will try to first understand the static indeterminacy and kinematic indeterminacy of the structure. As you know, this is the figure which I have tried to explain the static indeterminacy. So three reactions that will be generated at support A, and three reactions will be generated at support D. So total six reactions are there. Minus of three will give you three. Okay, three static indeterminacy. Now going to kinematic indeterminacy, as you can see, this structure will sway like this, and the value of that is considered to be delta. The translation of this sway is considered to be delta, and then there are two internal joints. At these two internal joints, there is supposed to take place the rotation. So that is why delta, theta B, theta C are the three kinematic indeterminacy of this structure. Okay, so once you have solved for static indeterminacy and kinematic indeterminacy, we will try to understand the fixed end moments of this structure, right? So this is element AB and this is element BC. So element AB is subjected to concentrated load at the center. I hope you can solve this fixed end moment. 60 into 4 divided by 8 will give you the fixed end moment of AB and BA, which is minus 30 and plus 30. Now similarly, you can solve the fixed end moment for member BC, which is W, which is 40 L square 4 square divided by 12, right? So from that you will determine how much is the MFBC and MFCB. As you know, there is no load that is acting on the member CD, so that's why MFCD and MFDC is equals to 0. So once you have solved the fixed end moments, next step is to determine the slope deflection equation. So first let us understand how we have solved for MAB. MAB is equals to, we know this equation, MFAB plus 2EI by L into bracket 2 theta A, 2 theta B minus of 3 delta by L, okay? This is the equation which we already know. In this, we keep on substituting all the values that we have. MFAB is minus 30, 2EI by L means L is equals to 4, length of this member is 4, and as we know, theta A is equals to 0 because it is fixity, so theta A gets 0, theta B and 3 delta by L, minus 3 delta by L is well left over, and well, this is the equation that I have written, okay? Now similarly for MBA also, you can write down what is the change that will happen. This MFAB is substituted with MFBA, and here it is EI theta B by 2, here it will become EI theta B, okay? That is the only change that will happen. Now going to MBC, MBC is MFBC plus of 2 EI by 4, okay? L length of the member BC is 4. Into bracket 2 theta B plus theta C minus 3 delta by L. As we know, 3 delta by L would get cancelled because the translation is taking place only in the columns, not in the beam. So the beam is subjected to is not subjected to any kind of translation. So that's why delta is equals to 0. So what we have is theta B and theta C. After simplifying this, this is what the equation I get. This is my third equation. Now going to MCB. MCB is equals to MFCB. MFCB is how much? 53.34 plus of EI theta B by 2 plus of EI theta C. Okay. You try to evaluate how you get the other equations. Okay. Now this is MCD and MDC. In this, we do not have the fixed end moment, so it will become 0. And theta C exists. Theta D doesn't exist because there is a fixity. So this will get 0. So minus 3 delta by L. Again, we have to consider delta because this column is subjected to translation. So after simplifying, these are all the equations that you will get for slope deflection, okay? So once you have solved the slope deflection equation, we know that the next step is to solve the equilibrium equation and try to determine the unknown values that we have, Okay, so what are the unknowns that we have? Ei theta b, ei theta c, and ei delta. So three equations have to be formulated to solve the three unknowns that we have. So the three equilibrium equations are like this. Summation of all the moment at b should be equal to zero, which means that mba plus mbc should be equal to zero, which we have written. Next one is summation of moments at c should be equal to zero, which means mcb plus mcd should be equal to zero. Okay, the last equation will be with respect to the whole frame. Considering this whole frame, we are using this equation called summation of horizontal forces in the frame should be equal to zero. So if you sum up all the forces, horizontal forces that are acting on the frame, they should be equal to zero. Okay, which basically means like this, I am assuming that the HA is in this direction and HD is also acting in this direction, which means we used to consider that this value as positive, this direction as positive and this direction as negative. Henceforth, HA plus HD should be equals to 60, or HA plus HD minus 60 should be equal to zero. So this is what our equilibrium equation is. Okay, now we'll try to solve this equilibrium equation. So I told you how to solve the reactions in all the previous cases. Again, we'll go back to that basics itself. First, what we do is that we take the structure and we divide into several elements. So those elements are considered to be simply supported, and considering them as simply supported, we try to solve the reactions. Okay, first what we need to do is that we need to take the column AB and CD. So for AB member, there is a point load that is being subjected, a concentrated load at the center. So by this understanding, we can say that the reaction that will be generated only because of this load is 30 kN. Okay. Now similarly for CD, it is not subjected to any kind of loading, so that's why the value will be equal to zero here. Okay, so this becomes the reactions that are solved from the external forces. What was the next step? Next step is that we use the equilibrium equations that we generate. Okay, so the equilibrium equations that are generated, from that we use to calculate the reaction, right? So now let us take this columns. Okay, these two are the columns. Now the end moments that I observe here will be MAB, MBA for member A and B. And for member CD, we will have MDC and MCD. So this is your CD member. Okay. So these are the end moments that will be generated. Okay. Now I do not know what will be the direction of the moments. Right now I am considering all of them to be positive. Okay. So let us consider. Let us assume that all the end moments will be of positive in nature. Okay. In that case, the reaction that will be generated at the columns from the end moments itself will be calculated, right? So see here, m dash ab is equals to minus of mab plus mba divided by 4, right? You try to take the summation of all the moments at b is equals to 0, which means ra into 4, the length of this column is 4, plus of mab plus of mba will be equal to 0. By simplifying that, this is what the equation I'll get. So ra dash is equals to minus of mab plus mba divided by 4. Similarly, we can write the equation for rd dash. Okay, rd dash is representing the reaction that is generated only because of the end moments, so which is equal to minus mcd plus mdc divided by 3. 3 is the length of the column, right? So once we solve ra and rd dash, let us try to evaluate what will be ha. As we know, HA is the sum of the reactions that are calculated from the point load or the external load and the end moments, right? So we know that RA dash is what? RA dash is the reaction that is calculated from the end moments. So we know how much it is. We have already evaluated, plus of 30. 30 is what? This is the reaction which is generated from the external load, right? So we know what is HA is. What is HD will be equals to? HD will be equals to RD dash. As we know, that the reaction that is generated from the external load is equal to zero because there is no external load acting on the member CD, right? This is what we know. Okay, now let me substitute this RA dash plus 30 plus of RD dash back into this equation, right? We know what is HA. HA is what? RA dash plus of 30. So what is RA? RA is equals to minus MAB plus MBA divided by 4. See here, this is your RA plus of 30, which you have to write from this equation, minus of mcd plus mdc divided by 3, which is representing our hd, minus of 60 is equals to 0. Okay, now if I simplify this equation, this is how I simplify it. MAB plus MBA divided by 4 plus of MCD plus MDC divided by 3 will be equals to minus of 30. So this is your next equilibrium equation. So now, what is MAB plus MBA? We already have developed the slope deflection equation. So from those slope deflection equation, we can write what is MAB plus MBA divided by 4, which is this equation. Okay. Now similarly, we can calculate how much is MCD plus MDC divided by 3. So we know the slope deflection equation of MDC plus MCD. So you solve it and you will get this equation. Now we need to add these two now. Okay. We need to add these two equations now. After adding these two equations, this is what the simplified version that I get, which is 0.375 EI theta. Sorry. This is EI theta B and EI theta C. Okay. So 0.375 EI theta B plus of 0.667 EI theta C minus 0.632 EI delta is equals to minus 30. Now, three equations are generated. This is my first equation, which is based on summation of all the moments at B is equals to 0. This is my second equation, which is generated based on summation of all the moments at C equal to 0. This is the third equation, which is generated based on summation of all the horizontal forces in the frame is equals to 0, right? So three equations, three unknowns. After solving it in the calculator, this is what I get. EI theta B is equals to 24, EI theta C is equals to minus 14.78, EI delta is equals to 46.117, right? So once you solve these unknowns, what we do is that we substitute the values of these unknowns back into the slope deflection equation and we solve the end moments. So after solving the end moments, this is what I'm getting, okay? MAB is equals to minus 35.3, kilonewton meter. Okay, now at joint B we have MBA and MBC, which are 36.57 as magnitude. With respect to MBA and MBC, it is positive and negative values. Okay, now similarly we have calculated for MCB, MCD and MDC also. So these are your end moments. Now this completes the solution of end moments. The next step is to solve the reactions, and after that we can solve for shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Okay, I want you to solve the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram by yourself and send it to me. Okay, if you find difficulty in solving it, you may ask the question afterwards. I will try to clarify the doubts that you have. Okay, I hope this is clear. If you have any doubt with solving this problem, if there is any step that you haven't understood, you can inform me so that I can repeat it again. Okay, thank you so much.